once said that it's almost to the point where your mouth goes dry talking about it now.
True.
You are aware, though, that a lot of people hold that record in very high regard.
Yes, so do we. So do we. I think maybe we've just been asked the same question over and over and over again, so it's like a bit like a record for us. Not so much, not so much tell us about Fever, but tell us about what happened after Fever. That's where we get, you know, we don't want to talk about that. It's like, you know, we were slapped around for having had a very successful album and we didn't like it. And it made us very unhappy for quite a long time. We've outgrown that now. And now we, like everybody else, we sort of look upon Fever with some sort of reverence, like, you know, actually it was quite a wonderful time. Why do we feel uncomfortable with it? So we don't feel uncomfortable anymore, you know? I think the media got the illusion that Saturday Night Fever, that we were a disco group because of Saturday Night Fever, and it's really an apparition. It's an illusion. It's not. We're a group that had many, many platinum records before Saturday Night Fever.
What we did, we're very proud of. To us, the music of the 70s, the late 70s, was never disco. We weren't a disco band. We'd had 3 platinum albums before Fever came along. We were quite happy doing what we were doing. And the music for the film was our new album.
We're going to go on and endeavor to make more. We're not really going to concentrate on being something that the industry seems to think we are, and it's not true.
But where the Bee Gees are concerned, they have very little to do with the movie and the whole process and the whole package of Saturday Night Fever. The only thing we had to do was 3 songs, and one of those was a ballad, and we had nothing to do with what they called the disco explosion. That was purely radio. We didn't even know what the film was about. We used to take the music, go on with the film. And we didn't see it again much later until they showed us some rough cuts.
We had no idea it was a film about a disco. In fact, disco was never even mentioned until after the album was released. But it became a dance phenomenon.
To be criticised for having had success is a difficult thing. Is a difficult thing.
Look, I don't know. I think people forget that we're also human beings. You know, we also have feelings too. You know, sometimes. No, but you do have feelings. I mean, we don't read reviews. We don't read press articles and things like that anymore. We used to get very upset when we were kids if somebody said something wrong about us or bad about us. But you know, it's negativity starts coming in all the time. You know, you're going to be miserable. You know, and it's not what we want to be.
We often come under fire for having done a disco album, or what people termed as a disco album in that period. I still object to. I always have objected to it, because to us it wasn't really a disco album. We were just doing another album, and that How Deep Is Your Love to me could never be termed as a disco song to me. It just never could be. So I'm proud of that music. Even today, I still think it's good. It's good, solid music for us anyway. And should never be put down by the disco haters.
Disco to us was like Casey and the Sunshine Band and stuff like that, and we were more into this in-house New York R&B type music. You know, it was entirely different from disco. How Deep Is Your Love was certainly not disco. And you come to me on a summer breeze, keep me warm in your love, then you softly leave, and it's me you need to show. How deep is your love?
I don't think, if you were a music critic, I don't think you'd be right in saying it was a disco song.
Mm.
It's a song.
It's just that it was connected with the disco image, you see, unfortunately.
It's easy I think, for the world out there to slag you off and just say, oh, great, it's the Bee Gees again, you know?
Yeah.
Mm. And then, for your own headspaces, do you even pay attention to that? We're songwriters, we're singers. Let's get on with what we do.
Yeah, well, I resent the idea of people out there slagging us off, and I don't want to do an interview that's going to be like this thing.
All right, fire
no, on. I don't. I'm sorry.
No, I don't understand that.
Here you go, then.
Yeah, I just don't want to.
No, I mean,
I
that's...
Again. I mean, it's all yesterday, I just sped up.
What happened
No, I just had a bad time at an interview yesterday, but just slagged us off, and it's just something I'm sensitive to.
And it's like...
No, I just don't,
used
yeah.
to being slagged off, or do we like it? I mean, do you two get the same questions? Do Genesis get the same questions as that? You know, it's like, that's just silly. Yeah. We don't feel that we get
I just feel
off.
That,
we don't
that I, you know...
If we are, you know. It's just, it's an unimportant question. Really is.
Since, in a lot of the years since Saturday Night Fever, we've taken a lot of crap. And I think a lot of unnecessary crap as well. You know, this is one of the most successful bands that music has produced, that has happened in the last 20 years. I think we deserve more respect than we've got, or that we've had.
We've tended to go through different periods. We went through the disco period along with everybody else. I mean, Paul McCartney made disco records, the Stones made disco records.
Rod Stewart, those were me.
There is a tendency for everybody to jump on the bandwagon and if the bandwagon's big enough, you know.
And if everybody had jibes about any clothes that we wore, everybody in those days was wearing the same clothes, including Genesis, Queen, and everybody else.
That's all.
There's been a resurgence of our music in clubs and rave clubs. And yeah. And I'm always on the floor with the crazy, crazy grooves. Tell me, can it feel the mad skills coming with the
fever? People love dancing to it. You know, it's just something that I think is great memories of the 70s that they love, that they didn't live through, that people are trying to live through now.
Yeah. It's come full circle again. Yeah. Yeah. It has come full circle.
Blitz.
It's like the World War II, really. Yeah, it's just amazing how, as I say, the culture loves all that sort of music now, because the younger people never experienced it. They just heard about it. Now they're going through it because they want to experience it. And the folks that do remember it like remembering it, so they're going back too. But we're moving forward.
Yeah.
And we always have been.
You know, we were slapped around for having had a very successful album, and we didn't like it. And it made us very unhappy for quite a long time. We've outgrown that now. And now we're like everybody else. We sort of look upon Fever with some sort of reverence, like, you know, actually, it was quite a wonderful time. Why do we feel uncomfortable with it? So we don't feel uncomfortable anymore, you know? We're proud of it now.
I think the thing about Fever is now it's beyond us. I mean, you can go into any nightclub in the world, they'll play a modern dance track, and then you'll hear Staying Alive, or You Should Be Dancing. Yeah. And they'll play something from Fever. And it's the same with, all over the world in any nightclub you go in. So it's part of not just pop music culture, it's part of the modern culture too. You'll just hear it. And
so, you know, you can stand outside. You can stand outside any club, which I have done.
Which you have.
And not been able to get in and still be able to hear my music inside.
Yeah.